Hello, my name is Danilo Varejos, and I'll be telling you a bit about what's new with GeneXus 18 in terms of the chatbots generator. First of all, I'd like to give you some background in terms of what we are talking about when we talk about chatbots. As a definition, we could say that a chatbot is any kind of software that seeks to mirror conversation with between humans. However, we have all come across some chatbots that don't give you that feeling. So that's why I'd like to divide them into two broad categories. First, scripted chatbots, and then NLP, which stands for natural language programming. The first ones need to get specific instructions, such as a command line or a phone hotline with option 1 for one action, 2 for another. Whereas you have NLPs, which seek to understand the underlying intentions in a conversation that resembles a bit more what would be human language. But, well, the question is, does GeneXus allow us to do this thing with chatbots? Yes, since GeneXus 16. So what is new about it? Well, first of all, I'd like to emphasize the huge progress that GeneXus has made in terms of the UI and UX. And this is mainly due to one of the main pillars of GeneXus 18, which is the new design system called Unanimo. All of our interfaces are Unanimo-based, which makes a huge progress. We're also leveraging this time to improve how easy it is to integrate chatbots to already existing interfaces. And this is something that we did by adopting a master page that enables that task. As I was telling you, Unanimo and its design system is one of the main pillars of GeneXus 18, so I'd really like to encourage you to take a look at one of the talks that appear on the screen. Another of the main functions that GeneXus 18 has in terms of the generator is dynamic scripted chatbots. This new way in which we can build our scripted chatbot seeks, as its name says, to make it more dynamic when it comes to modeling. One of the main features that scripted chatbots have is the possibility of having modeling in runtime. So it means that through an application that has been generated, you will be able to edit in runtime the flows of your conversational assistants. And another main feature is that it's independent of the GeneXus IDE. This allows you to model new ways of working around the creative process of our conversational assistants. Thanks to the independence, or to a greater independence, let's say, of a GeneXus programmer. One of the features that we really didn't want to miss was the possibility to be integrated with knowledge-based objects. That is why our dynamic scripted chatbots can integrate with all the already existing KB objects with which we are generating our chatbots. But the best thing to understand it better, I think, is to give an example. So I'm going to give you a demo. And in this case, we're going to be using a pre-existing KB with a banking theme, which has already some transactions and procedures that we'll be using in our example. And the flows that we'll be modeling are the following. First, we will have a list of all the active cards of a customer. And secondly, we will have the possibility of disabling one of these cards. So as I was telling you, for this example, we are going to be using a banking-themed KB, which, as you can see, has a couple of transactions and procedures that we will be using in this example. First of all, we're going to create a conversational object, which I'm going to name New Banking Demo. We'll go to properties, and here, because it is scripted, we are going to indicate that the NLP provider is none, and that it is dynamic. Then when you save, GeneXus will import all the necessary resources and generate the applications that we will need to be able to model in real time these scripted chatbots. Once we have finalized that, as you can see, we have this module where you can find this main panel. And if you run that, it's going to take you to the application on the screen. We have the panel that is going to allow us to edit the different flows associated to our instances. As you can see, we've already integrated an assistant so that we can try out these new changes that we've made. Dynamic scripted chatbots are based on structures which are generated in databases by the generator, and they support all the flow and all the power of our chatbots. What you can see on the screen are some flows that come as examples, where, for example, you can trigger it by writing the word hi, and in this case you get a reply. But you could make an update and you will see that really fast. For example, if you go here, you can say that now whenever you have the hi word as an input, it will request your name. So we're going to call this input as name, and as a message, we're going to write something like, how are you? So we will click on confirm. And then in the response, you can choose what the user said. So for example, as a message, instead of saying that, it will say hi and name, which is the name of the user input that we have just created. We confirm. We click there again, and there you go, you can try it. So now if you write hi, you will get a response that it says Danilo, and then it will give you a greeting with your name. So what we said was that in this example, we wanted to interact with some objects that were in the KB. And for that, we will start by creating the first flow that will support this. And this is going to be a little menu that is going to tell us what are the options that our chatbot supports. So we're going to create a flow name called menu. And as a trigger message, we're going to have hi bank. And as a response, we're going to write a message which is going to deploy the different options, the different existing options. I have it here, so I can just paste it for the sake of time. So once you click on confirm, you can just try it out. So you write hi bank, and it will deploy these options. So option one, for example, is to list my active cards, and option two is to disable a credit card. So we're going to start by building the same flow. For this, we go to insert. Because we have not selected the instance manually, it's we get that pop-up warning. So it's easier to just go there and say that we want to assign it to this instance. But because we have only one, but you can have as many as conversational objects you have in the KB. So for this, we're going to write list cards as a name. And then here, we're going to make reference to the conversational object in the KB. So that is a KB object. So if you remember, for this case, we had a couple of existing ones. And for the list active cards, we're going to use this procedure here, which has as a parameter in the signature an input and an output parameter. In the conversational object, we will have to select the qualified name which is the name and module where it's found. And we're going to take it from there and we're going to paste it here. So now we have to indicate here in a new message what is going to be the message that that flow is going to trigger. In this case, it was option one, if you remember. And in user inputs, we're going to have to insert an input parameter. So we're going to write a name, which is going to be user. Here we're going to indicate the position in which it was in the method's signature, the message that it is going to send to request that. We click on confirm here and here. And here in new response, we're also going to indicate that it has an output parameter. So we're going to call it cards. An output parameter that is also going to be called cards. And here you have the message that you want it to deploy once the flow is ended. And in this case, we're going to write active cards. And with ampersand cards, you're going to make reference to the output parameter that you have just created. We click on confirm. And there we can try it. So if you write one, it says, could you tell me your user ID? I have a user ID that is called one. So this is going to give me a list of all my active cards. I have an active card that is the one that you can see there on the chatbot. And so now we are going to move on to the second process. The procedure is basically the same as we just did. Again, you get this warning pop-up message that says that you need to select it. And well, it's basically the same thing that we did for the previous point. So we're going to write disable the name. We also have to make reference to the KB's conversational object. So in this case, we're going to go to this procedure, which is disabled credit cards. The trigger message here is going to be option two. And the same thing, we're going to have to map out the user input and the user output for this procedure in responses. So we go to user input and we are going to call it card number. Position is going to be number one. And as a message to request those data, the message is going to be, please give me your credit number. We click on confirm. And we also have to indicate an output parameter, which we're going to call result. And then also the parameter is going to be result. And in this case, as a message, I'm just going to deploy the result of this operation, which makes reference to the output parameter that we created just now. We click on confirm. And this flow is available and up and running. So if you enter option two, which is disable credit cards, you will have a request to insert your credit card number. I'm going to copy this one here. I'm going to paste it. And then it says that the credit card has been disabled. So in this case, if you list all the active credit cards, it's going to tell you that no active credit cards were found. As you can tell, we didn't get the request again for the user input, for the user's ID, and that is because we had already written that in the previous case and it was stored in the context. And well, that's all as far as this example is concerned. Well, so as we've seen, GeneXus 18 gives us more power in modeling, more flexibility in changes, and a better user experience with an interface that is based on Unanimo. That is why we would like to invite you to update your versions to GeneXus 18 and keep on building chatbots with these new features. That's all, friends. Thanks a lot, and let's see you next time.